The entire picture-taking process takes only about 5 minutes per animal. You can see the value of this device in selecting animals for breeding purposes. Scientists are able to select the most promising animals from these pictures and breed them with other animals with the same desirable characteristics. This is another example of how modern technology is working for us, helping to provide us with the highest possible quality in our food.
We can now use sonic waves to check the meat-bearing ability of live animals. After selecting the cut of meat we want from the supermarket, it has to be cooked. During the warm weather, many families like to broil steaks outdoors to get that good smoky taste in the meat. No one knows exactly when man got the idea that cooked meat tasted better than raw meat, but it might have happened like this.
The origin of cooked meat is lost in antiquity, but very likely its discovery was accidental. Today, we wouldn't think of not cooking our meat. Let's take a closer look at one of the modern methods of cooking, broiling. This is familiar to all of us. It's the basic item used for outdoor charcoal broiling. The cooking is done by radiant heat from a broiler, an uncovered pan or grill. This is called dry heat cooking. Roasting is the same type of thing. When water and heat combine to form steam or hot liquid, it's the moist method, such as a stew, or this piece of meat wrapped in foil. There are advantages to dry heat charcoal broiling. First of all, it's fun. The house doesn't get all heated up. The fat content of the meat is lower. A good part of the fat drips off during cooking. There's a variety of kinds of meat suitable for charcoal cooking, and of course, the true charcoal taste can't be duplicated. Making a charcoal fire is really very simple. Just make a small pyramid of charcoal, or as we're using in this case, charcoal briquettes, which last longer. Make it right on the fire base. Pour some starter fluid on, let it soak for about a minute, and then light it. The coals will be ready when they're covered with gray ashes, like this. This usually takes about a half hour. Then you just spread out the coals into an even layer and start cooking. What to cook? Well, many people are learning that the world of charcoal broiling need not be confined to hamburgers and hot dogs. In fact, it's possible to charcoal almost anything from the meat department. Just remember, the cut and grade of meat will make a difference in tenderness. For example, a loin cut will be more tender than a shoulder cut. Look for the specials and get the highest grade of meat you can get. Let's look at some of the cuts you might be charcoaling. Beef offers the greatest variety. For tenderness and juiciness, small cuts should be at least an inch thick. Porterhouse or T-bone, club, sirloin, tenderloin, and shoulder steaks are some popular cuts. Some people use well-marbled round steaks. 8 to 10 minutes of cooking on each side is usually enough. Test for doneness by making a small cut into the center portion to see if it's rare or well done. If you want to try something larger, like a rump roast or a standing rib roast, it would be advisable to cook it on a rotisserie for even cooking. Use a meat thermometer to ensure doneness. The same procedure applies to lamb and pork roasts. The thermometer will let you know when the center of the roast has reached the proper temperature. Pork chops and lamb chops are ideally suited for charcoal grilling, but be sure to cook them well done. And also, don't forget the meal on a skewer, shish kebab. Tender cubes of lamb or beef and cubes of vegetables or fruit make shish kebab an all-time favorite. And of course, chicken is an excellent meat for charbroiling. Since it has a low fat content, be sure to baste it with your favorite sauce while it's cooking. The joints will break apart easily when it's done. Make sure that the salad and everything else is ready when the meat is done, so you can enjoy the meat while it's good and hot. Well, now you're an expert on charcoal grilling. First chance you get out your old hat and apron. Have yourself some fun, and eat well with your charcoal grill.
Ham is one of our most popular meats. But like beef, we often get confused about the many cuts of ham and the terms used to describe it, like cured and smoked.